The MAD Fellowship provides freedom for graduate students to explore in their areas of passion and to bring their design skills to the world's problems.
I really want to help address one of the pressing issues that our generation is facing, which is climate change.
The crisis of biodiversity is also a crisis of ethnodiversity. We need radically different ways of consuming, producing, and restoring.
I believe that design is able to expand the way that we approach not just our industries and the impacts that we have on the world physically, but literally our relationships to each other, our relationships to the ecosystem, our relationships to the past, to the cosmos, and everything beyond.
Every year, our MAD Fellows tackle a range of challenging problems.
I study floodplain agriculture. My project has two objectives, climate change resilience and food production.
I'm studying nature-based solutions for coastal adaptation, specifically how different configurations of oyster reef restoration strategies influence wave attenuation.
My current PhD project is on designing a new architecture for a high-pressure hydrogen storage tank for CO2 mitigation.
Design has a deep, deep history at MIT as a way of translating technology and creativity into the world.
The project that I'm working on is the connection between how students learn in a technical class and how students apply that knowledge in a project or in their career later on.
I like to say I'm kind of a musician at heart, maybe a designer and an engineer at hand, and a neuroscientist in mind. I build instruments that are a combination between a medical instrument and a musical instrument.
How might we use human-centered design to design last-mile transportation delivery networks that will really enable us to help communities that need it the most?
I want to help astronauts be able to have the tools that they need to solve a medical crisis when a life could be at risk, and I'm hoping to use automation to be that tool.
I'm a graduate architect by profession. We have a lot of interesting tools coming out in the generative AI space, and we could leverage the power of these tools to make architecture more accessible to a lot of different people.
My current project is related to this idea that we can actually control the behavior of a fabricated object by modifying the distribution of material inside of that object. And I'm so excited to learn from everyone else and, you know, different corners of design that I hadn't thought of.
One thing that I'm exploring is using textiles and physical making techniques in order to both reflect on and archive histories within different diasporas.
I don't think a single person can accomplish the whole design by himself or herself.
My approach to design, I sort of like to think of it as a multi-species approach, where it's not just, you know, the people living on the coast, but it's the oyster, it's the larval fish, it's the birds.
I generate conditions for two things that would never get to speak in real life to meet and grow generatively.
I feel inspired seeing the amount of resources and support that we get. It really makes me feel hopeful for the world.
We continually come up with solutions to overcome any hurdle that kind of stands in the way of better understanding our world or the universe.
And the MAD Fellowship is really a gift. It's a gift for students to be able to do their work without worrying about where their support will come from. But it's also much more than a gift. It's about building community around design. It's about learning best practices, sharing with each other, and ultimately elevating design across MIT and around the world.